Hello everyone and welcome back to Brooke's Beauty Bazaar. I hope you guys are all doing really well. As promised, in today's video, I'm going to be talking to you guys about two new sunscreens that I have been using and loving that are both fungal acne safe. Now, I have not really mentioned these ones before, so that will be new for you guys. And then in addition, if you stay tuned to the end, one is from a brand that I have used from before, and I'm gonna compare the two sunscreens from that brand so you can decide which one works better for you. So stay tuned all the way till the end so that you can get that information. And without further ado, let's just go ahead and get straight into this. All right, you guys, so first item up is the Elta MD UV Clear Broad Spectrum SPF 46. And you guys are probably like, what? I thought you said you've never talked about these before. I did mention this one in my previous sunscreen video, but I hadn't actually gotten my hands on it yet. So now that I have, I wanted to just give you guys my opinion on this particular sunscreen. So first of all, good things about it, it is SPF 46, so broad spectrum SPF 46. It has a really nice consistency, so I'm just gonna put a tiny dot on to the back of my hand. You can see it doesn't move around too much, so it's got a nice kind of medium weight to it. And when you rub it in, it is shiny but goes in clear. So that is nice. I do have like actual thicker sunscreen on my hands already, so if there's a little bit of a white cast, just trust me when I tell you this really doesn't leave any white cast at all. Now, this one is also formulated with 5% high purity niacinamide, which is vitamin B3, to help reduce the appearance of blemishes, discoloration, and photo damaged skin. It is ideal for daily use for various skin types. Now, Elta MD, I'm not sure if you guys know this about their brand, but they are specifically formulated and targeted at people who have skin conditions. So this particular sunscreen even talks about at the bottom here, it is safe for skin types prone to acne, rosacea, and hyperpigmentation. So if you fall in one of those categories, welcome to the club, this is for you. Now, about this product, what I really love about it is that it is really good protection. When I put this on my face, I don't get any sunburn, nothing happens to me, and it's really good. I do feel like it's got a good little bit of hydration to it, and it feels really nice when you rub it into the skin. There's not really much of a fragrance to this at all. You put it on and it dissipates pretty quickly. And I don't know, I really do enjoy it. When you put it under your makeup, it does kind of act as that primer for your makeup, and you get a good little bit of a youthful glow to your skin, which I think is really nice, and that glow can show through your actual foundation. So that is a real plus on my side, because with fungal acne, you'll notice there are so many mattifying products out there that we end up having to use in the makeup, you know, arena especially. And so I think having something that you can kind of use as a primer plus a sunscreen that is anti-aging for you is pretty much the perfect thing. This is 1.7 fluid ounces, 48 grams, and it costs 30 some odd dollars. I think the price kind of goes up and down on Amazon, which is where I usually buy this from. I will link this below for you guys. When you are using this regularly, so like every single day of the summer, you're probably going to get max 2 months of use out of this, maybe only 6 weeks if you're a little bit more heavy-handed. However, this is gonna be your number one anti-aging ingredient, so it's kind of, honestly, a lot of bang for your buck when you weigh out the pros and cons, but I do understand it is a little bit expensive, so it might not be for everyone. Just wanted to put that out there. Okay, let's move on to the next sunscreen. So this sunscreen I'm equally as excited to talk to you guys about because I wasn't even aware of it before and I'm absolutely in love with it already. It is another sunscreen by Paula's Choice. This is the Paula's Choice Clear Ultra Light Daily Hydrating Fluid Broad Spectrum SPF of 30+. And it is formulated with antioxidants and particularly also for blemish prone skin. So these are actually very similar like marketed products. This one claims to hydrate without clogging pores and help prevent UV damage and signs of aging. So anti-aging, UV protection, and hydrating without clogging pores. I definitely would agree with that statement. I don't think this clogs your pores at all. Again, like your Elta MD, this one comes out white, and I have to do it a little bit different, put a couple drops there. Now, it is a lot more fluid. It's got a much lighter texture to it than the Elta MD, but you can see you can put some on the back of your hand and it goes, rubs in very, very easily, and it's clear, and it leaves a little bit of that shininess to your skin as well. So in that regard, this one, just like the Elta MD, is perfect for using as a primer, like a glowy primer underneath your makeup, and I totally have been benefiting from that all summer long and absolutely loving the effect. The only thing about it that like makes me a little sad is that it's only 30 SPF. Which is fine because 30 is the minimum that you want, but this one is 46 SPF. But it's such a hard thing because between the two of these, I actually favor this one just because I love that fluid texture to it. And I don't know, you also get a little bit more bang for your buck. So whereas this is 1.7 ounces, you get 0.3 more ounces, which is not a lot, but 2 fluid ounces and 60 mil. And for whatever reason, where this one only lasts about 2 months, I feel like you could get 2.5-ish months out of this one. So I feel like it goes a little bit further just because it's so fluid. It doesn't take that much to like rub into your skin and get everything covered. I can't remember if I said this already, but both of these are awesome because they're not sensitive to like your eyes or anything. So I can literally rub these over my eyelids and I don't feel like it causes me to tear up or have any extra problems. So really they're around the same price point, around the same amount of bang for your buck. And both of them honestly are super, super great. The one thing that I will mention is this Paula's Choice does have glycerin in it. So if you guys are like on the anti-glycerin train, which I'm not, but some of you are, this won't be for you, but the Elta MD would be a really good option. So we have gotten to the end of the video, and as promised, I did just want to quickly compare and contrast 2 Paula's Choice sunscreens with you. If you guys have been watching my videos for a long time, you will know that I am a lover and avid user of the Paula's Choice Youth Extending Daily Hydrating Fluid Broad Spectrum SPF 50. These are all like such mouthfuls. Now, this one is from their Resist line, so it's like really for the anti-aging crowd, which is me because I'm 30 now. And it is formulated with antioxidants and soothing plant extracts, so it's got a little bit of extra added stuff to it. And then it is water-light fluid that minimizes the appearance of pores and helps prevent UV damage and signs of aging. So this is pore reducing. This one is non-clogging, is how they're kind of marketed, and then both of them are anti-aging UV protection. This one is amazing because it's 50 SPF, whereas this one's only 30, and the price points on these are very similar. You get the same amount of product and everything, and they're the same fluid consistency that I love. Both of them have glycerin in, so just side note on that. But this one is going to be like the perfect face primer for your makeup, as far as like you get a kind of more mattified, like filled in pore look for real. Like if you're somebody who really wants that texture of a primer that fills in your pores, this is going to be the choice for you. If you're someone who doesn't necessarily want that, but you want more of a glow primer, this one is going to be for you. I am obsessed with both of these products, and I will just say everyone else in the world clearly is too, because during the summer, these are particularly hard to get your paws on. So you might want to order 2 at one time just to keep up with your sunscreen habit. I just wanted to say these are both probably my favorites, and I probably will order both of these before I order this one again, just because I like the consistency. I like the way my makeup looks underneath them. As far as bang for your buck, if you really want to be honest, since they're both so similar and all the actives and everything are the same as far as like their formulation, this one has 50 SPF and this one only has 30, so I would probably gear more towards this one. But if you're trying to have a glowy, dewy skin moment, this is the one you want. So why not just get both? That's kind of what I'm gonna probably be doing forever going forward. Just wanted to mention that. That was a lot of information and a little bit of time, but I hope you guys feel a little bit more informed and excited to go out and maybe try one of these sunscreens. Maybe there's something here that you've been looking for and it'll help you. So I hope that it does. If you liked this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up for me. I would really, really appreciate it. And if you would also press subscribe, because I love fashion, beauty, pop culture, and all the shiny things. And if you do too, there's gonna be more where that came from. I am going to be focusing still on fungal acne type content, but in addition, I'm going to be sharing some of my cosmetology school journey with you guys, and then hopefully soon I'm gonna get into doing a little bit more fashion and stuff like that. that, because those are other things that I really love in my life and would love to share on this channel. So I hope you guys are all doing well. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.